Okay, I think this much you are clear. So the how we are entering, how we are doing the initial setup in this template that we were discussing. So here I was discussing that depending on your questions, the level of your question paper, you have to enter UPRE, that one, this column. Okay, remembering, understanding, applying, all those things. And what is the maximum mark for each question? That's also you have to enter here. And the first question for CO1, second question for CO2, third question CO1, second question is also CO1, the third question is CO2, then remaining all questions are CO1. That's also you have entered here. Then this column contain what is the maximum mark we have given for CO1. Means here you can see from part A we have given 8 mark for CO1. Then from part B we have given 16 mark from part B, but it is or question, means either fourth question or fifth question. Means fourth question carries 8 mark, fifth question carries 8 mark. So the maximum mark we can take from here is 8 for CO1, and from part A it is also 8 plus 8 16. This is the reason in the beginning I told you both the questions should contain the same mark distribution for all COs. It can for CO1 and CO2, the fourth question contains CO1 and CO2. The same mark distribution you have to follow for fifth question. Otherwise, you cannot enter that one in this column. Then the CO2 carries 4 mark for 4 mark from part A. In part B, it contains, there is no any question related to CO2. So CO1, the maximum mark of this question paper, it is 20. In the top, we have given that one. It is 20 mark. Among that 20 mark, 16 mark from CO1 and 4 mark from CO2. That we have set here. Then the same thing you can enter here also. CO1 it is 16 mark, CO2 it is 4 mark. Then another important thing. Normally here we are following, for a particular course we are defining maximum four COs. You can define any number of COs, but as the number of COs is increasing, the calculation will be difficult. So here we are following maximum 4 COs, and the series 1, series 2, all these things are to us evaluate that CO. So it is not mandatory that CAT 1 or series 1 to address all COs. It may address CO1 and CO2. Series 2 may address CO2, CO3 and CO4. The last series, if it is there, it may address all COs. Like that, different combination will be there. So due to that reason, these two columns, this column and this column, it is for CO3 and CO4. And we are not using that column right now because series 1 is only intended to CO1 and CO2. Then after you are entering, after you are setting this much things, that is the maximum mark and what is CO1, CO2, and the bottom level, what is understanding, remembering, and maximum mark up to this column, you can enter the mark here. So before you are entering mark, there is one more thing you have to set. This column, it contains what is the maximum mark which it is attained by a student for CO1. So question number 1 for CO1, question number 2 is CO1, then 4A, 4B is CO1, 5A, 5B is for CO1. Means D14 and E14, this column. D14, E14, similarly I14, J14, K14, L14. This much columns are for CO1. So you can write down the equation, sum of D14, sum of D14 here, E14 here, then skip this one, then I14 to L14. That will be the sum. Okay, so 3 plus 1 plus 4, that is 8, it is here. Then the CO2 is as such our F14. Okay. So you can just give sum of F14, that is F14 itself. Keep CO3 and CO4 blank because we are not using CO3 and CO4 in this exam. Then drag this one up to bottom. Then automatically this column will contain the sum of this column. Mth column contains the sum of D, E, I, J, K, L. Similarly, nth column like the sum of F. So different combination depending on your series and your COs, you can type the formulas here. This is the one formula you have to type. There is no other formulas you have to type in this template. Then when you are entering the mark, that time also you have to be careful. I'll take one sample paper. See, this one is one sample paper. Question number 1 contain 3 mark. Question number 2 contain 1 mark. Question number 3 contain 2 mark. Again, question number 4 contain 3 plus 2. Means, question number 1 is for CO1, 2 for CO1, 3 for CO2, 4 it is for, 4A is 3 and 4B is 2. Like that, you have to enter the mark here. 3, 1, 2. Then, if it is 3 plus 2, you can type 3 here. So, from here it is 3, 1, 2. Okay, you can type 3, 1, 2, and it is given here. Question number 4 is 3 plus 2. Means you can give 3 here, then 2 here. Okay, then sometime that student may write the answer for 5th question also. Then what we have to do is we have to choose one of the question from there. Because if we are writing this question also, it will be on the maximum mark 16. Then our calculation will be wrong. So from this template, in the work question 4 and 5, one of the mark we are supposed to enter. Even the student is have written the answer for both the question and we evaluated both question, one of the mark we are supposed to enter based on this one. Okay, like that you can enter the mark also here. After you are entering the mark and you are dragging this one to up to here, what you will get in the column number M, the CO wise mark of each student, CO1 mark of each student, CO2 mark of each student, like that if CO3 and CO4 are there, that mark you will get. Then we are coming to bottom point again. We have said among 20 mark, 16 mark is for CO1, 4 mark is for CO2. Then now depending on facilitator, we are setting threshold. I am saying if one student is able to 60% of total CO1 mark, I am saying that student attained CO1. Means if I am giving 10 mark for CO1 instead of the 16, I am giving 10 mark for CO1 in this exam. And that's one particular student scored 6 mark out of this 10, then I am saying that student is scored that CO1. It can be 50%, 40% or 70%, that depends on a facilitator. So that is the competence 60% threshold. So here you can see it is 79.6. This 0.6 means 60% of 60. 79 means this column, 79M. So 60% of 16, that is 9.6. So if you are changing this threshold, you have to just change this 0.6. It can be 0.6, 0.5, whatever it is, depending on your percentage. Okay, similarly, here also you can see N79 into 0.6. So what is the threshold you are setting? That depends on that one, the 60% or 70% of that CO1 will appear here in this column. This is our threshold. Then after you are setting this much, there is nothing you have to do because automatically it will give the count how many students among this 61 scored more than 9.6 in CO1. Similarly, how many students among this total number of 61 scored more than 2.4 in CO2, that is the total number of students. After you are setting this much, the series 1 paper, that is over. Series 1 evaluation, this sheet is over. Then next we are going to evaluate. Actually this name, there is one mistake. First one is assessment, second one is evaluation. Leave it about that one. Anyway, I am saying this is series 1 assessment. In this page, what we are doing is quality of question paper based on revised Bloom's taxonomy. So the based on the value you have entered here, 4, 4, 4, and UPRE, this one, the maximum mark and the level. Okay, actually you can see, even though it is 20 mark question paper, the total mark we have given here is 28, means 4 plus 4 plus 4, 12, it is compulsory. Then 8 plus 8, it is optional. So 12 plus 8 is 20, but the total mark of what we have given in this question paper, that is 28, means 12 plus 8 plus 8, it is 28. Among that, only 20 mark is we are evaluating. So for this 28 mark question, how many questions are in remembering? How many mark of the questions are in remembering? 28, 4 mark is for remembering. 28, 4 mark is for understanding. 28, 8 mark is for applying. 8 mark is for evaluating. This sheet automatically generate here. Depends on the value what you have given here. The mark as well as UPR. The you are never give a small letter, give the capital letter itself. Okay. Then after that, we are calculating benchmark and attainment. This is important for us. Benchmark is, if 60, here we have said 60% of students, sorry, for 16 mark, total 16 mark, the 60% of 16 mark, that is 9.6. How many students attained that one? That is 43. Then we are here also the facilitator setting benchmark. If 60% of total students, that is 60% of this 60% of total student, that is 61, attained this 9.6 value, that is 60% of this 16 mark, that is attainment level 1. Okay. Similarly, 70% of total student, 70% of this 61 students attained 60% of CO1, that is 9.6, that is attainment level 2. Similarly, 80% of total student attain 60% of our CO mark, that is 9.6, or in CO2 it is 51. In CO2 it is 2.4 is the benchmark. So 80% of total 61 student, if they are attained more than 2.4 or they are attained more than 9.6, that is attainment level 3. Okay, so here also you have to, in this sheet, second sheet, you have to enter only this one. Point, what is the total student strength? 62. Okay, it can be 61 also. And what is 60%? What is the target benchmark you have set? 60%, 70%, 80%. This one depends on a faculty. It can be from faculty to faculty, it can change. Similarly, this also depends on a faculty. Competence level. This benchmark also depends on a faculty. So, after you are entering this one, here attainment automatically calculate. Okay. Then next, the remaining session, I will continue in the next video. Thank you.